Hey guys, it's TownieSimBuilds here, and welcome to our first special edition holiday build. Today's build, as you can see, is from the 2012 animated movie Rise of the Guardians. This film was made by DreamWorks and was originally based off a series of books by author William Joyce. Now, as a special note, this film is celebrating its 10-year anniversary, so I was really excited to create something unique for it. So, with that said, let's head on over to the world of Mount Komorebi and check out North's workshop. Alright guys, and here we are with a full view of the lot. As promised, we are in fact in the world of Mount Komorebi. And to be honest with you guys, I think this was the best lot to build this in. We do have perpetual snow here, so it definitely made recreating this a lot easier from a builder's perspective. But as you can see, it is a pretty mountainous build. I had to rely on a lot of different debug objects. And I believe these rock pieces and the crystals are from the Realm of Magic pack. I was really trying to simulate the idea of different ice sculptures and ice crystals kind of forming the land. Now, the building itself is kind of weird, if I'm being honest with you guys. It's supposed to be a Russian-inspired palace, but it does give me very strong log cabin vibes, and it does resemble a mosque. So it's definitely a strange structure overall, but it is pretty magical nonetheless. What you guys saw is North's runway. It pretty much goes through the basement of the build, and then he does have a watchtower of some sort towards the back. Now, if you guys are like me and you've seen the movie, I really love those little adorable elves, and I did create little huts where they can, in fact, live. These are, in fact, seen in the movie. They are seen in the opening sequence, along with the concept art for the film itself. But zooming back out, we will check out the lot in different forms of lighting. This was currently the morning view, shifting on over to the afternoon, onwards to the evening view, onto the night view, and finally back to the morning, where we will take a look inside. Starting off our tour, we are in fact looking at the little elf cabins, and these pretty much emulate the same style as the workshop itself. And upon entering, we do have 5 in total, each with 2 beds. Taking a closer look, a lot of these have their own skill objects. That cabin has an easel. This one has a small violin with a songbook. This one has the embroidery kit seen from the cottage living pack. And moving over here, this one does have a gramophone on the nightstand, with the final cabin having a little library for a quick read. Now heading downstairs, each of these cabins does have the essential living components. So we do have a very tiny kitchenette seen on the right side there with a lot of content from the cottage living pack. And we do have a tiny yet full bathroom there as well, along with a trash bin. So it is fully functional and your elves can live here very cozily. Continuing our tour is North's Watchtower, and unfortunately I don't think we get a look inside of this, but I did make the base level a sort of storage room. But heading on towards the upper floors, it pretty much is just a large spiral staircase leading up to the very top. And at the topmost floor, of course, is the Watchtower area. So we do have 4 telescopes. They are positioned on each of the different corners of the tower, and they are in fact fully functional with how they are positioned. So starting off our tour of the actual workshop is in fact the basement level. And there are a lot of very interesting areas here. What you guys are seeing now is actually the runway for North's sleigh. And it is seen in the movie, it is pretty much this giant ice tunnel, and I tried to form it using a lot of the Realm of Magic crystals. This, of course, is North's sleigh, and I kind of had to improvise. I used the jet ski that came with Island Living, but with a combination of different objects, I was able to get it somewhat close to the one seen in the movie. But moving on inside, we do enter the stalls for the reindeer. As you guys know, we don't have reindeer in The Sims 4, but I thought, hey, you know, llamas are the next best thing. They are the mascot of the game, and this can function as a little farm area if you wish to do so. So we do have the stalls from Cottage Living, and within the tower portion of the basement, I did include a small feeding area. So there is perhaps some fresh produce, some fresh vegetation there for your hungry llamas. But moving out over here, this is the sleigh repair area. I honestly thought this could be a good place for the sleigh to be stored, but we do have a workbench here. We do have a variety of tools, towels, and a trash bin there as well. Now moving to the right side, there is another really cool feature that unfortunately isn't really playable, but this would be the washing station for the reindeers themselves. Again, this would be for the Sims 4 llamas, so we do have a hose, we have buckets, towels, and a drainage system. Completing the floor is a employee bathroom of sorts. So if there are Yetis, if there are elves on the job, this would be the perfect place for them to take a break, use the restroom, wash up. And of course, if you are playing on this lot, it is definitely convenient having a bathroom on the first floor. Heading on up to the next floor, we now enter the heart of North's workshop. So this area is pretty much where a lot of the toy creation process happens. And as you guys can see, we do have a lot of different workbenches. This was pretty much where a lot of the Yetis were working in the film, so we do have some already constructed toys on the side, mainly dollhouses, airplanes, and helicopters. Over here we have the large wheels seen vaguely in the film, but they are pretty prevalent in the concept art, and I do believe they power the whole workshop. This side, again, is another toy making station. We do have some model cars, we have some presents already wrapped, along with rocket ships and the robots. The robots are a little Easter egg to a really funny scene in the opening clip. Unfortunately, the Yeti just finished painting all the robots blue. Santa comes by and says he wants them red, and the poor thing just slams his head on the table. It's a pretty funny scene, so I did want to include that. But what you guys are looking at now are the bedrooms of the Guardians. This bedroom was designed originally for Pitch, but given his evil ways, I don't think he would ever reside in the workshop itself anymore, so there is a little bit of garland there sealing off his room. Now his counterpart, the lovely Sandman, does have his own room. It definitely is designed to fit his style, his color scheme, and it's a pretty fun little mystical place. Each of the Guardians do in fact have their own ensuite bathroom, so again, if you have the Guardians in your game, you can definitely play very easily as them. But moving on in, we have the office of the boss man himself, North. This is seen in very, very extreme levels of detail in the movie, so it was very hard for me to bring it to life. There were so many different stills I had to reference, but this is his workshop area within his office. He does have the model train set with the ice sculptures there. He has a giant fireplace. He has his own private woodworking area, and then he does have some cabinetry towards the front as well. Now, I don't really know what he does here, but I think he drafts more toys. There are some different books and different things for tea or coffee if he needs to stay awake all night. And, of course, a Christmas tree and shelf full of toys. But moving out, we will get to the staircase leading to the next floor of the workshop. Moving up to the next floor now, we do enter the last area of the toy making station, along with a very iconic space you guys will very well recognize. This area is what I created to be a doll making station, and I didn't want to include a repetition of woodworking benches everywhere, so I did include the embroidery set that came with the cottage living pack. We do have a lot more wrapped presents here, so I figured a lot of toys would be finished in terms of production and brought up here to be prepared for the kids. Over here again is another sewing or embroidery station here. And the fruits of labor are along the wall. There is quite an array of different stuffed animals. Again, perfect for the kids, and plenty more presents to wrap. Moving over here, we do enter more bedrooms of our favorite Guardians. The first bedroom is the bedroom of Mr. Jack Frost himself, so it definitely fits his vibe. There are snowflakes, a lot of the interior is very icy and gray. But he does have some games, he has some sports, he has Don't Wake the Llama, so it's a pretty cool room to hang out in. The next room is for the lovely Tooth Fairy. This was a really cool room to design. She has a very ornate style in the world she is from, but there are a lot of rocky and mountainous type of features in her world, so I did want to use a lot of the Realm of Magic elements to kind of bring this space to life. But heading on out over here, we have the very iconic central fireplace. So this is seen very heavily throughout the film. I believe this is where Jack Frost is originally made into a guardian, if I'm not mistaken. But we do see this area quite a bit. And towards the back, we don't really see this area, but I made it a nice little reading nook. I do know that there are a variety of different bookcases everywhere, so I figured it was the most logical thing to create. And of course, moving out is the staircase to the final floor. Completing our tour today is the topmost floor of the workshop, and as you guys can see, there is a very cozy fireplace area right when you come off of those stairs. But circling back to some of the notes I mentioned earlier, there is the large central globe. I'm sure you guys are super familiar with that from the movie. And in terms of the giant balloons, those are also a reflection of the movie as well. North has a lot of these different types of flying toys around. I think some of them may be airships or hot air balloons. So I did want to include that detail. I think it's pretty fun and whimsical. What we're looking at now is the main dining room. This is a feature I added to this build, so I figured that if the Guardians were dining here with the elves and the Yetis, this would be a really perfect place to do so. On the wall is the man himself, that is North, but that is his younger self. If you guys have seen the books by William Joyce, that is actually pretty close to how he is illustrated. Moving over here, we enter the bedroom of Bunnymund, or better known as the Easter Bunny. This bedroom is probably my favorite. It was a lot of fun to design, and it took a lot of cues from the world he was from. So the giant stones are like Easter eggs, he has a lot of foliage there, and he does have a full rocky floor as well. This bedroom is, of course, for North himself. So we do have that nice dark red color, just like in his suit and his outfit. And because he is quite a warrior, I did include a knight in armor and a sword and shield crest there. Now, his bathroom is interesting. It's actually the only one to feature a full window, which I thought was pretty interesting. It juts out there, so I did move the toilet, kind of situated nice and cozy there. But moving on over here, this is the final place seen in the film, and this is the kitchen. This is the kitchen seen in the workshop. A lot of the elves are misbehaving here. They're either trying to make cookies or are eating them themselves. But this is a really great place to prepare your ultimate Christmas meal. Now, looking at the lot specs as a whole, this is in fact a 50 by 50 lot, so it does fit perfectly on that one lot in Mount Komorebi. However, it can also fit a lot of Sims 4 worlds fairly easily. Now, if you do want to keep the snow and have everything looking like it does in this tour, I definitely recommend that Mount Komorebi lot. In terms of lot type, this is set to residential, so if you want to play as Jack Frost and the other Guardians, this is definitely a great lot to do so. Now, in terms of packs, we always stick with our 4-pack limit. This build obviously incorporates Space Game, but it also includes content from Get Together, Island Living, Cottage Living, and the Realm of Magic pack. Now, technically, there is a 5th pack, which is the Holiday Celebration pack, but like I always say, this pack is free, so you don't have to worry about buying it. Alright guys, and that is a wrap on North's workshop from Rise of the Guardians. As always, you know I love hearing all of your thoughts and feedback in the comments, and if you are a fan of the movie, just like myself, definitely let me know if you think I did the workshop justice. Hopefully it brought back some favorite memories of this film, and hopefully you do watch it this Christmas as well, given that it is the 10-year anniversary and all. And with that, this has been TownieSimBuilds, signing off. Thank you so much for watching, guys.